Welcome to the Garib Rath fiasco. The court has ordered the Indian Railways that the Garib Rath from Chennai to Nizamuddin cannot be cancelled and it should be run in the same slot. And if Humsafar has to be run, it can be run in another slot. The Humsafar is a high-end three-tier AC sleeper service. This is a big blow to the Indian Railways, and let us look at what made the Garib Rath so special and popular among people, and what are the future implications for the passengers and to the railway. Introduced in 2005, the Garib Rath was conceived as a poor man's chariot with subsidized air-conditioned travel. Completely a three-tier air-conditioned sleeper service, 34% cheaper than the normal three-tier AC trains. No onboard catering, no bedroll, and the trains were run in fact as fast as Rajdhani's at a maximum speed of 130 km per hour. There are currently 26 Garib Rath trains operational, including the Chennai Central Nizamuddin weekly service. The three-tier coaches had a middle side berth, which is not there in the normal coaches, making it 78 berths. Chennai Nizamuddin fares, Garib Rath the cheapest, 1380. Indian Railways passenger service are being non-profitable, and on top of that, the Garib Rath services is still lower and making it very loss-making service. But Indian Railways started as a populistic measure by using old ICF discontinued coaches from the Rajdhani Expresses, which were converted to LSB, and they thought that they will replace that with Humsafar, the new premium three-tier AC services. The problem is that the ICF coaches are getting older and their maintenance issues are cropping up, and replace non-profitable services or get rid of them. But the court has put a stop on the cancellation of these Garib Rath services. But how long can these services be run? What next? What options do public have? What options do railways have? One is for the railways to use standard LHP three-tier AC coaches, not the Humsafar coaches. And the second one is to be very cautious about offering subsidized travel services in the future. Now, what about the public? What choices do they have? We must remember that we are only paying less than 50% of the actual cost of travel that we incur. That means the railways is recovering only 50% of the cost. So what do you think? Please give your opinion in the comments column. Thank you very much for watching this video, and see you soon again with some more interesting videos like this. Thank you and have a great day.